In Greek mythology, Artemis is the twin sister of Apollo and goddess of the moon. Project Artemis is NASA's plan to return to the moon by 2024 and set out to go further than any human has gone before. Now you are probably wondering, this has been done before. On 20 July 1969, Apollo 11 successfully landed on the moon, and although the destination is the same, the motivation behind Project Artemis is very different from that of Project Apollo. NASA want to develop a permanent presence off Earth by 2028 with four main motivations for this endeavor. To bring inspiration for future generations, just as Apollo 11 inspired a generation 50 years ago. A prolonged lunar presence that provide opportunity for invaluable scientific research, humanity's desire to explore, as well as economic reasons to establish a space economy built on mining and tourism. How will NASA reach the moon again? The Space Launch System, SLS, is the rocket responsible for launching the Orion exploration spacecraft on our journey back to the moon and beyond. SLS is being designed to be adjustable and evolvable to make provision for a variety of space-oriented goals, such as sending humans and support systems deep into space. The rocket will tower over the Statue of Liberty, being almost 100 meters tall, with a mass of approximately 2,600 metric tons and providing a thrust of around 39 meganewtons, which is equal to the thrust produced by about 39 Boeing 747s. The rocket has an expected payload of 26 metric tons while being able to carry at least 45 tons with future upgrades planned down the line. To successfully carry the payload into space, the core stage holds 740 kiloliters of liquid oxygen and 2000 kiloliters of liquid hydrogen. After powering the space shuttle for 30 years of operation, the RS-25 rocket engine will feature once again, this time on the Space Launch System with a few slight modifications. The rocket engine's nozzle insulation will be adjusted and a new electronic controller will be integrated to match the performance requirements of the SLS. The same four-engine configuration will be used on the SLS throughout its evolution. How will SLS evolve over time? The first generation of SLS is known as Block 1. The first evolution, Block 1B, will use a more powerful exploration upper stage and will be capable of carrying a payload of 37 tons, including Orion and its crew, into deep space. Block 2 is the subsequent configuration and will provide 35% more thrust than that of Block 1, and will be the workhorse spacecraft for sending cargo to the moon. Block 2 will be capable of lifting a payload of more than 45 metric tons. What is the Orion spacecraft? The newly designed Orion spacecraft will be used to carry four crew members. The spacecraft has been designed to safely transport the crew and everything they will need to live and work in space for a total of 21 days. Orion features an emergency abort capability known as the Launch Abort System. This system is located atop the crew module and can activate within milliseconds to ensure the crew's safety and position the module to ensure a safe touchdown. Orion provides safe re-entry from space with a heat shield capable of withstanding temperatures of about 2200 degrees centigrade. If you have any topics that you would like to see discussed on Genius Engineering, let me know in the comments. If you did find the video entertaining and informative, be sure to click like and subscribe for more insight into interesting topics. This video is thanks to a collaboration approach by Caleb from LearnHole. Over on his channel is a video on the economic approach and implications of the NASA 2024 moon mission.